Well, I'm Brian Lilley, and the demise of Sun News, that is the topic of tonight's Byline. Wasn't expecting it to end like this, but then again, maybe you don't always, things don't end the way that you think they will. But early this morning, yes, Sun News Network went off the air. It's been a wild ride. It's been fantastic. I was one of the first employees announced. David Aiken and I, we call ourselves employees number one and number two. And we shook hands goodbye, took a picture in our studio before we left today. And it's almost 5 years from when we walked in to the Sun Media Ottawa Bureau and said, "Hey, we're here." It's been almost 4 years since we went on air and started talking. There's been a lot of controversy over that time, but a lot of good stories and a lot of breaking stories. People will dismiss us if they want as not having an impact. We had an impact, and we told stories that nobody else was bothering to tell. From my first monologue, which was on Mulrooney the opera and the $1 million wasted on by CBC on that, an absolutely horrible production, didn't even have a single hummable tune, and CBC spent $1 million on this, then walked away from it and took their name off of the credits because that's how bad it was. I had to go watch it and then tell you about it. That was my first monologue. That was a story that nobody else was telling you. Can you imagine another government department wasting $1 million frivolously and getting away with it? Wouldn't happen. It would be a lead story everywhere. And then the last monologue that I got to do, the last big story that we got to cover, the High River gun grab. I was saying for more than a year and a half that the RCMP broke the law. They did illegal search and seizures. They stole people's guns. Well, guess what? We were right. And that was the last show last night. So, yeah, we went out on a high note, and it was good. And in between, we had all kinds of Sun News victories. People who have been asking me since last night when the news broke, what's going to happen now? I don't know. Is Sun News coming back? No. And you can protest the CRTC or call your MP all you like. It's not going to change a thing. The company that owned Sun News, which was ultimately Quebecor, they decided to pull the plug. So we're done. We're being shut down. But that doesn't mean that we're gone. You're going to see myself again. Well, I'll surface somewhere. You're going to see Ezra again. You're going to see Michael Corrin. You're going to see David Aiken. You're going to see the daytime folks like Alex Pearson and Pat Bolin and Adrian Batra and Jerry Agar. You're going to see the contributors like Paige McPherson and Faith Goldie. You're going to see Marissa Samke. You're going to see Chris Sims. You're going to see Addis Levinsky. All these people are going to come back. You're going to hear from us in some way. Will it be as one single entity, as Sun News? No, it won't be as Sun News. Will some of us work together again? Probably. I worked with John Robson and Chris Sims and Daniel Proulx all before at 580 CFRA in Ottawa, where probably some of us are going to work together again. Speaking of CFRA, I was on the radio there for 2 hours this morning talking to the CFRA Nation, and there's a lot of crossover between lovers of Sun News and the CFRA Nation, and it was great to spend 2 hours having people tell you, "We loved you, we love what you did, we love seeing you on TV, we love the stories you tell, and we're angry, but we're going to miss you, and we want to see you again." So that was a bit therapeutic, and I'll make sure that I've posted the audio from that by the time the weekend's over. So keep an eye here, keep an eye on social media, and you will see us again. I'm curious by nature. It's why I became a reporter. I have lots of opinions. It's why I became an opinion journalist. And there's still lots of stories to tell that the other guys will not touch. I'm not going to leave those alone. So continue to drop by. Please continue to spread the word and share what I produce here. And who knows where we'll see each other again. And that's the byline.